Like I said, this is our eighth round of the challenge. So a lot of things are different. And I'm going to explain all of that. So if you've done my challenge in the past and you're like, okay, I've already done it. Is it going to be beneficial to me? I think it will be. And I'm going to explain why. All right. So let me go ahead and get going here. I'm going to show my screen. We've got a long weekend, and this is really important. So I've got a long weekend discount on the challenge. So if you sign up before the end of Monday, you will save 25%. What I want to go over is the 6-week challenge. It's going to start September 13th, and this is actually coming up fairly quick. I didn't give you guys a whole lot of time to think about this. So not this Monday, but the next Monday. I really kind of wanted to hit the ground running. Kids are back in school. Parents, you're kind of already feeling like I've got the routine down. This weekend might be a little bit different. This is like the last hurrah of our summer. But now we've got our routine. Kids are going back to school. You're trying to now get back into what you used to do. And I've even had a lot of comments of, like in my DMs about, oh my gosh, I've really like let myself go over the summer just because I wanted to soak it all up and enjoy myself. But now, like our motivation can kind of be in the crapper after a summer because we're like, well, that was fun, but I don't really want to go back to working out and eating better and all that. So I'm going to help you with that. Okay. So let's go over all of the question and answers, but it does start September 13th. It's going to be right around the corner. And do not wait. Before Monday, you can save 25%. So if you're even on the fence, you have till Monday to really save some money. Okay. So this year, I am incorporating all of our coaches. So just last year, Julie joined the Fitness Life. She is our newest coach. Logan and I are the founders of the Fitness Life, my husband Logan. I'm actually going to do a Facebook Live with him tomorrow. For those who don't know the background of Logan, he is an athletic trainer. He used to be an athletic trainer. Like, so after he graduated from Boise State, he went to Indianapolis Colts, the NFL. Yes, everyone always is like, what? Really? NFL. Then he for like 8 years worked with the PGA. So men, you can join this challenge, and Logan's going to help us. So he's going to be here with us. So I know having a female coach sometimes weirds guys out, but Logan will be here. So all three of our coaches are going to be involved this year. Check them out on social media. I'll make sure I tag them so you guys can go all follow them and give them some support. They have a lot of knowledge to share with us. So this is exciting. So just some outside of the professional photos. I love to deadlift. I'm assuming that most of you follow me because you're here. Love to deadlift. I am all about the strength training for us females. I really like to make you girls feel badass and showing you that you can. If you recently watched my Facebook, I had my client Monica. She just hip thrusted 245 for 10 reps, like it was nothing. So I've got a lot of success for clients, making them feel confident and strong. I also have male clients. So men, I'm gonna frequently say female just because that's what dominantly I train, but I do train some men. Julie is really, really good about giving some good visuals with form. She's got a lot of little nuggets. We call them nuggets. Inside our group, we call them actually Julie's gems. She listens to a lot of podcasts and she always loves to share them with us. So she's got a lot of good insight. So females, us coaches, we all kind of come back, we come around, we come from damaged backgrounds with nutrition and training. And so we really help you with the mindset of things too. And then Logan is just being a badass. This is a still picture of him warming up for his golf. So because of his PGA experience, he does do a lot of like golf fitness and he can explain that. I'll have him explain that in the live. I'm not very good at explaining it. So, okay. All right, so if you are kind of new to my page, I just want to do a brief little background on how the whole fitness life started and why the challenge is the way it is. This will kind of help you feel a little bit more comfortable about what this challenge is really going to do for you. Okay, so back in, I call them phases. Okay, so phase one is when I was dealing with depression and I was eating everything. Like I ate absolutely everything in sight. That phase of my life, it was eat all you want, no rules, whatever, how much, and then you'll just run it off. Because I'm a runner. If you guys follow me, I like to run. I'm one of those weird people who really actually enjoy to run. So I really like to run. And that was just fine to me because I was like, okay, I'll eat whatever I want and I'll run 4 to 5 miles all week. And I would run 4 miles 5 times a week, and I would just do whatever I want. And then I would feel really, really guilty. So, I'd eat all I want. Oh my gosh, I'm going to go for a run. I'm going to work it all off. And then I'd feel a little bit better and then back down. It was just this yo-yo effect. And I wasn't getting anywhere. If you see this photo, I've never been super, super big because this guilt of eating all the food, I'd never let myself get that big, but it wasn't like a healthy weight either. I probably weigh less than I do right now. I'm sitting at 165, just to give you guys some numbers. I'm sitting at 165. In that photo, I was always terrified to get over 150. So I bet you anything in this photo, I don't weigh over 150 because that was that number of like, oh my gosh, you can't get over this number. If you were slightly depressed before you hit 150, can you imagine what you would be like after 150? So I never let myself get there where phase one was a shit show. I'm just gonna say it was a shit show. It was terrible. So then I went to the complete opposite. I went to phase two, which was my competition phase. I extremely dieted. I call it the bulldozer effect. This is if you've ever heard a female go, that's it. I'm cutting out carbs. I'm cutting out sugar. I'm not doing anything. And men sometimes do this as well. So I'm, like I said, I just frequently say female because that's what my population is. This bulldozer effect of that you're going to wipe everything out. This is kind of what I did. I went from no diet, no restriction to like complete restriction. Right now, if you even say tilapia to me and oatmeal, like I can picture myself in my old house doing morning cardio, dreading. I had tilapia for breakfast one time because I was getting ready for a show. And yeah, I don't eat tilapia anymore because I can't stand it. And oatmeal. Now, some of you are like, oatmeal's not bad, but we're talking competition oatmeal. Like it's water and oats, and that's it. Maybe some cinnamon, but that was it. So, tracking my macros, I definitely started lifting more. I backed off the running and I started lifting more. And then this was definitely the smallest I've ever been. I stepped on stage at 135 usually. Okay. So, I just gave you some numbers. Okay. So, think back. I never let myself get over 150 because I was freaking out in phase one, right? Now, sitting here, I weigh 165, I think. I'm pretty close to 165. On stage, I weighed 135, smallest I've ever been. I was like, yeah, I'm on top of the world. I felt amazing, right? Like 9% body fat is when I stepped on the national stage in New Jersey. And I didn't even get anyone's attention. Like it totally crushed me. But after, that loss, I was like, okay, I'm trying to like pep talk myself up. I'm like, okay, you're going to rebuild. You're going to get bigger. You're going to get leaner. You can do this. And then at that point, everyone has the scale, and you might not know it, but you have the scale of what I'm doing. Is it worth what I'm missing out on? And so, all of these social events, morning fasted cardio, tilapia for breakfast, and then like not being able to go out for drinks with my friends, not being able to have dinner with my husband, date nights. And like it was just not weighing out. And I was like, okay, screw it. I'm done. Like it was. Like a year and a half after that show that I finally allowed myself, because I was kind of worried after competition, like what was going to happen? Like, would I allow myself to get back to phase one where I was kind of chubby and I was eating all I wanted, or could I have something else? And I didn't know. I didn't trust myself because all I knew up to this point was the what the hell effect. And that's actually an effect we're going to talk about in the challenge. Like, what the hell effect? I was just eating what I wanted or very, very strict. So I wasn't sure if there was anything in the middle. And so then finally, when I was like, I think I can do it, I started playing with allowing foods back into my life a little bit. I then came out with phase three, which is now. This is the fitness life. Okay. It's a work in progress, but this is my goal for everybody that is looking at me right now. This is my goal for you. Okay. Phase three, you have a better relationship with food. You have a better self-esteem. You have more energy and it's sustainable. Okay. And you feel more confident and you feel amazing. And you feel amazing in like your body. Like you look badass, you look strong, but you also feel really good. I don't know if any of you have like done fasted cardio. You don't feel awesome. You're not like, I was on my bike. I wasn't pedaling like I was in a race. I was like dying. I'm like, this is dumb. You're like counting down the seconds. You don't feel great because you don't have any carbs in your system. And so, phase three is what I'm going to coach everyone in the 6-week challenge to get to. Okay. So if you are sitting here, I know you've probably gone through your own phases. You've probably done some sort of diet. You probably have done some sort of program, and they've all been super, super restrict, right? I've always hear from clients is like, oh, I used to do keto. It worked really well. But I also want you to think about this in this phase. If it worked really well, then why are you here looking for another solution? If it worked, it means you can sustain it. That's the true definition of it working. I want you guys to rephrase that in your head. Finding something that works means that you're not going yo-yo. We're going to get rid of this yo-yo effect, okay? Of going up and down, feeling great, feeling like shit, up, down, whatever. Okay. I want it more of like allowing to live life and have that balance. And that's why it's called the fitness life. So my 6-week challenge, what I did when I first started my 6-week challenge is I wasn't going to create a challenge where, okay, the biggest loser wins. Not, you do not win my challenge by losing the most weight. You win my challenge. It's a point-based challenge. You are going to succeed by checking tasks off, and that is going to help you outrun a bad diet. Like, I didn't want you to outrun a bad diet, literally, when I was running 4 to 5 miles a day. I don't want you to run yourself into the ground. We're not going to do the bulldozer effect. I am not actually going to tell you to not eat anything in this challenge. This is always the mind-boggling thing for people. In the 6 weeks, I never, ever, ever tell you, do not eat X, Y, or Z. Okay. I'm going to show you how you can eat the foods that you love. You can drink whatever you want to and still reach your goals. Okay. We're going to build balance. Okay. Me and my coaches are going to help you. And why, how we do that is we give you direction. All right. No more second guessing what to do. Right now, you will probably know that you need to eat better and probably move more, but you're like, well, how do I actually approach that? Your first instinct probably is to cut out all carbs, and then you're probably going to then work out 5 or 6 times a week. But what are you going to do in the gym? The exercises that you've always done? Or are you going to go to aerobic classes? Are you a runner? Are you going to go run? Or are you just going to like get on the stair mill? Like, you don't really know exactly what to do. So I'm going to give you direction. We have rules to follow throughout the nutritional challenges. You're going to kind of check these things off your list, right? So you're going to like, okay, this is what I need to do for this week. And we break it down week by week so that you're not overwhelmed. Because I oftentimes always hear people like, when I first start fitness, you feel like you have to take everything on, right? And what we do is we break it down week by week and slowly adjusting your nutrition to get you the results that you're looking for, whether that be weight loss, muscle gain, and those are pretty much it, weight loss or muscle gain, or maintenance or just better physical health. Then that's how we're going to help you do that. And we give you the confidence to do that. So that's what all this challenge is about. So now if you're going, okay, so this is starting to sound interesting. You like the idea. So is this for you? The challenge is open for men and women of any age and all fitness levels. The exercises that I have you doing are not for like elite athletes. Don't think, oh, Allie, I'm going to like pat myself on the back really quick. Allie, you're a badass in the gym. Like, you lift really, really heavy. I am not to your level, so I don't think I can do your challenge. No. Okay. And even men, if you're looking at me like, Allie, I can totally outlift you. Your challenge is not going to be good for me. Like, think again, bro. But it's for all challenges. Okay. All fitness levels. If you are on this hamster wheel of dieting, okay. So if that whole, I did keto and it worked, if you've said something like that and you feel like you're just constantly getting on this diet wheel over and over, this is going to be good for you because we're going to start introducing new thoughts about nutrition. And we're going to give you those tools that you can actually, like, there's not a season for my approach. There's not, you know, you might dial it in a little bit if you've got like a wedding coming up or anything, but it's not like you're going to completely shut things off and you're going to gain 20 pounds. Okay. I'm going to show you how to sustain it. If you're not happy where you physically are. So I've had a couple messages this week. You know, like I said, summer you were traveling or you canceled your gym membership just because of COVID and you were like, you just kind of left the gym atmosphere, right? And you were enjoying life. And now you're sitting here going, oh, wow. Like, that went by quick. And I put on a lot of weight. this is good to get you back into it. You might not feel very motivated because you may be being the worst. Isn't that funny? Like when we are in the worst shape that we've ever been, you think that's when we'd be super motivated, right? But oftentimes, like that's when we're like the most defeated. Am I alone? Like, tell me if you guys feel that way. It, which I said, it should be the opposite, but you kind of feel like, well, I just, if I let myself get this far, like there's no point. It's going to take forever. And I'm going to help you give you some motivation and give you motivation in the fact that I'm going to build up your confidence. I love, this is what I love about my challenge. Okay. When we break it down to weekly goals, you're going to easily check off these little like tasks, and it builds up your confidence slowly. And you're like, okay, yep, I'm not where I was, but I'm doing good. And then it's going to like just steamroll into all of a sudden you're like, ah, I'm back to where I was, and maybe even better. Because then back to having a better relationship with food, you're not going to do any bulldozer effect to get there again. And you have something that you can sustain. Okay. So this is really, really awesome. And if you ever just feel lost about, there's so much crap on the internet too. So if you ever feel lost about what should you actually do to approach your fitness and your nutrition, we do customize this, giving people tips on what they need to do. So I said muscle gaining and fat loss. I have ladies who are very, very tiny who want to put on muscle. So their nutritional goals are the same as others, but it might be increased a little bit, like more protein, right? More carbs versus someone else who's trying to lose weight. And we go into all of that. So don't let that overwhelm you, that little tidbit, but we do go over all of this. So now hesitation, guys, hesitation allows cracks for excuses to crawl through. So if you've been wanting to get back into nutrition, get back into fitness, get back to yourself, don't hesitate, because that's when all of the self-doubt comes in. No, you're too far gone. Like no one can save you. Allie's really cool, but I don't think she can help you. Or, oh, she's a female. I don't like female trainers. Guess what? Logan's joining us, men. So that's not an excuse. Like don't allow that little voice to talk you out of it. If you at some point thought, ooh, I really do like the idea of earning points and getting rewarded for marking these tasks off, I think that will build up my confidence and get me going, then hurry and sign up. Do not wait any longer. Okay. So we've got some amazing ladies who've joined the challenge, who've all different sizes, all different goals. Like this is really, if you're wanting to build a balance and have some fun workouts. So this is Erica, her review. I'm just going to highlight that she likes our approach on working smarter, not harder. That is my life motto. I don't like to work harder than I have to. So let me just quickly go over the point system, because with that hesitation, it goes, well, Allie, how intense is it going to be? Oftentimes people think I'm going to tell you to work out like 6 times a week. I am not going to make you work out 6 times a week. This is about balance. You can make results working out 4 times a week. So let's just go over this. Point system reward, you get rewarded for your daily water goal. This is going to change for anyone who's done my past challenges and you don't like drinking a gallon of water a day. I am going to give you a smaller goal, so it is a little bit more achievable. You're going to lift 4 times a week. I am writing up your program. You can do my workouts in my app. They all come with exercise demonstration videos, coaching, all of that is included. However, if you have a trainer, if you have a Peloton, if you have someone on YouTube that you like to follow, you can do any lift throughout the week, but you do have to do 4 lifts a week, okay? And 3 cardios. Now, if everyone's looking at this going, adding that up, that's 7 days. No, ideally there's days where you would do a lift and cardio. So you're not working out 7 days a week, like you would pair them together, okay? So 4 lifts, 3 cardios, daily nutritional challenges. Like I said, every week, and I'm still kind of trying to like tune these up a little bit. I want to change it. I want to throw some new things at you guys this time. Each week we have a goal. So our biggest popular one is a big ass salad. I think that's going to come back too. So the goal was to have a big ass salad 1 time a day, whether that be for lunch or dinner or snack, whatever. But, and then there was rules about like, it had to be bigger than your hand. It had to have protein in it, had to have some vegetables in it. So there's just some fun things like that. And obviously what that's doing is with a big ass salad, you are tricking your brain going, holy crap, I'm sitting down to this big plate of food. There's no way I'm dieting, right? But a big ass salad doesn't have nearly the amount of calories as a burger and fries, right? Equal amount of plate food, but you don't feel like you're dieting. And so it's going to like make you feel better throughout the whole process. Last one, my zone effort goal. We are going to have my zone heart rate monitor goal. So if anyone's new to my zone, this is what I wanted to do this Facebook Live because I got a lot of questions about my zone. So my zone is a hardware and a software with a wearable platform that uses technology to help people feel good about exercise, whether it's during, before, during, or after the event. Okay. MyZone is awesome for making you feel good about the effort that you're putting into your workouts. It is a heart rate monitor. So I have it right here. I have mine. So it can be worn around. The MyZone Switch, this is the new one. Okay. You guys are getting the new MyZone. And if anyone has it in the comments, will you guys let me know? Like, do you guys love your MyZone Switch? I freaking love it. So this is the MyZone Switch. You have the chest belt. So it goes right underneath your sports bra. You unhook this little device. You can then swap it into your arm or your wrist. And the coolest thing that they did about this, this is the brand new one, is that you can go swimming with it. So if I've got anybody who likes to do Ironman or just like to go to the gym and swim laps for your cardio, you can now wear this to track that. Okay. It charges by USB, so you don't have to deal with any cords. You have a bag to put all these bands in and everything like that. And you do get one included in your registration. Woo-hoo! Okay. So really cool. The biggest thing I found is that this one connects better. It reads better and it's swim friendly. So all of my swimmers really, really like that. Okay. And it's 99.4% accurate compared to an EKG. So it's really good. Now, I know the next question is, well, I have an Apple Watch. Can I do that with this? So here's what MyZone does differently. Okay. They show your effort while you're working out. And so you can see on my screen here, when you're doing it, there's colors based on what zone you're in. This is actually what the app shows. Now, with the new switch on this little device, there's like this little blinking thing. So if you guys have ever watched my Instagram where I'm running and I show you my watch, I can actually look down and see what color I'm in, what zone I'm in when I'm running versus I don't have to open up the app. Okay. So that's also another cool thing. If you've ever been accused of resting too much in the gym, this can also be an indicator. You can look at your heart rate and go, okay, I need to get going again. And that's also really important with your supersets. So the screen really quickly just shows you your effort, your heart rate, beats per minute, your MEP. So my effort points is what MyZone calls them. And you get a point based on which zone you're in. And I'm going to show you that in just a second. It also shows you calories burned. So it's very, very visual. If you are a visual person, you're going to benefit from this. I did put my name on it. If you guys are current MyZone users, go ahead and send me a friend request. We can be friends on MyZone. It's really cool. Okay. So I want to show you these zones. So gray is kind of like you're warming up and you get 1 point when you're in there per minute. And then blue, you get 2 points. Green, you get 3 points. And then yellow and red, you get 4. So here's the cool thing with MyZone is they didn't want to give you more points for being in the red because they didn't want, like, it's equivalent to being in the yellow and the red. They didn't want to push you guys to be in the red so much because red, you shouldn't be able to sustain. They didn't want to kill you is what they wanted to do. So we're going to use this to make sure that your effort isn't with the challenge. So you guys are going to get your good results that you're looking for. And I will also be able to monitor and see how your workouts are going and so forth. So this is a really cool thing with the MyZone challenges that we're going to be able to do. MyZone actually reported that people that use MyZone who have social connections, so we can be friends on MyZone, work out 41% more than people who don't. So if you're like, Ali, I can't work out. I never do it. I need some motivation. Voila. Here you go. This is your motivation. So MyZone is actually really, really cool. So this is just a little screenshot of like a live workout for me. So you can see down here at the bottom, all the green and the yellow. So you can see throughout my workout, I'm doing multiple different zones and you can see where you were. So really, really cool. This is included in your challenge. Another review from Melody. She said that she loves the workouts. She definitely felt lost in the gym before our workouts and now she likes them. So yay. Now with the pricing. So if you already have a MyZone, obviously you don't need this. you don't have to purchase it. The My Zone, without the My Zone, your challenge cost, you can see down here, is $89. You get home, gym, and hybrid workouts. So what hybrid workouts mean is, like last year, all of you went out and bought a bunch of like equipment for your home gym. So your home gym is not just a home gym with basic dumbbells. A lot of you went out and bought benches. You might be even bought a squat rack and bumper plates. So hybrid workouts are going to be, and on the website, it does show you what you need for each one of these, but hybrid workouts are basically a gym without cables, is really what it is. Okay. So I'm going to give you any different version of workout that will fit your environment. You're going to get those weekly nutritional goals. You're going to get 8 weeks in the app. You get full app access. In that app, you can also track your stats. You can see what weights you've used. My favorite thing about our app is when you do an exercise, it will show you how heavy you lifted last time and how many reps. So that way you're always getting that progressive overload and you're always going to be making results and you're going to get bigger muscles and see more fat loss. Okay. You're also going to get personal guidance coaching from us. So I think I'm going to go live on Zoom once a week instead of Facebook, because everyone's getting rid of their Facebook. And I have some people who signed up who don't have Facebook. So we're going to do Zoom. Me and my two coaches, we go live every week and we talk about, you know, okay, what are some hiccups you ran into? How can we readjust? What's coming up next week? What's our next nutritional goal? How can we prepare to get that? Any questions about workouts, pain, or how to get stronger, or any just comments, questions, concerns? We're going to go over that with you. You're also going to get our nutritional playbook. This nutritional playbook is over 50 pages. It's got meal plans in there. It's got pictures of protein ideas. It's got the stats on those proteins. It's got recipes. It's a really good book. Only our clients get that. So that's going to be a good additive to this challenge. It's going to really help you get ideas with our nutritional, our goals. And then cash prize this time. The one who has the most points gets the cash prize. So if you are new to MyZone, you don't currently have a MyZone, you can upgrade your challenge. You actually have to have a MyZone for the challenge. You get the new MZ Switch at a discount. This retails at $159. I'm not giving it to you that. I'm giving it to you at a steal so that you can join the challenge and benefit from this. And then you get all of what I just mentioned. So check it out. The value is well over thousands and thousands of dollars. So you guys are getting a lot of information and a lot of coaching for a quarter of the cost. They always like to compare this to personal training one-on-one. An hour of training with us is $65. So even at $89, that's like a session and a half, but you're going to get 6 weeks of three coaches, three absolute amazing coaches. So I know the MyZone kind of scares a lot of people. I've had a lot of hesitation about, well, I don't know if I want the MyZone. Guys, me and Logan have had our MyZones for, we're probably running on 5 years now. And the biggest benefit I think from it is it really kind of calls you out on your bullshit. On those days when you're like, I really am pushing it hard. Why am I not seeing results? This thing is 99.4% accurate. It's going to show you your effort. Now, I did mention earlier that it levels the playing field. So what that means is that your heart rate is based off of your age, your max heart rate, okay? So the equation is it takes 211, subtract your age times 0.64. So my max heart rate is going to be different than Logan's. It's going to be different than Jessica's. It's going to be different than Becky's. Now, the effort points are rewarded based on your zones, okay? So my 70% of my max heart rate is definitely going to be different than someone else's. So this is where it levels the playing field and everyone can kind of join the game, right? And if I'm in, so let's go back to, let me show you the screen again. If I'm in my 70%, I'm earning 3 reps per minute and somebody that is younger is in their 70%. Technically, they're probably working harder because they're younger and they have a healthier heart and, you know, it can go, 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 go. But we're both playing on the same level. We're both earning the same amount of points. That is the really cool thing with MyZone. And so no matter who joins this, the age of you, we're all able to compete. We're all able to cheer each other on and push each other to reach our goals. And it's just going to make sure that your effort is there. I really like it as a coach because there's those clients where you're like, okay, I want you to go 20 minutes on the elliptical. And you know, they're just do, 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 do. And I can sometimes say, okay, you know, put the resistance on this, make sure you're this, you know. But if I want to challenge them and really get them the results that they're wanting, then now I can use my zone to see the actual effort percentages. I can go on my app, I can see what they're doing, I can comment, I can like it, I can cheer them on. So as a coach, my zone has really bridged the gap between what I define as good effort versus the client. And now we're kind of on that same level of like, okay, like I know what you want from me and I can do it. Let's do it. There's also something to be said when you are on the elliptical. There's this picture. I'm on the elliptical and I'm staring at my MyZone screen where I feel like I'm really working hard, but it's not the color that it should be. It's like this game inside your head, like, okay, I got it. I can do it. Come on, come on, go, 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 go. And it takes the brain, it takes it off of the focus of, oh, my muscles are burning, I'm breathing hard, oh my gosh, I got sweat in my eye. Like it just takes it into a fun level of competition. And I think that's one thing as adults, we really miss out on competition. We maybe did sports growing up, and now we're like, now what? Like we've lost that. And now we're just kind of like, I need something to drive me. And this is it. This is going to be that competition that you're looking for. Okay. So make sure you check it out. Let me know if you have anything. Go ahead and send me a message, guys. It's going to be coming up and I'm excited. All right. Okay. Well, it's good to see you all here. I'm happy that you all joined me and I hope you have a wonderful weekend. Okay. Bye.